And when we graph this, it looks about like this. It's a big function that has the highest value at its center, 19, and it falls down in some interesting way that looks awfully much like the way that the previous exercise fell down. So even for this different experiment with the die, we get about the same phenomena that the sum of those seems to have a distinct high probability for what's the most likely outcome, 4, and then it falls off in some interesting way. So this is effectively what's called the central limit theorem. And that sounds complicated. In fact, it is, but here is the simple version to remember. Suppose you're doing many experiments. Each of these experiments over here have some distribution. We don't care. It has to just be reasonable. And you sum those all up for some very large number n. If n is large, then the joint distribution of the sum of those will approach a function that looks like this. That's called a Gaussian. We discussed the Gaussian in depth. It has its own formula. And typically, if n is as big as 30, that is, maybe you test 30 people, whether they have cancer or not, that's usually good enough to approximate this really complicated binomial over here with this relatively simple Gaussian function. We learn more about this later. The key thing to remember is you take many experiments, you add them up, and out comes a function just like this. That's called the central limit theorem.